Semiconductor Industry Comparable Companies Analysis Report on July 10th. We haven't included every company in the industry, but more the household names. We also didn't include equipment makers such as Lam Research, Applied Materials, or ASML. We are comparing Advanced Micro Devices, ARM Holdings, Broadcom, Intel, Micron Technology, Nvidia, Qualcomm, and Texas Instruments. Our individual reports on these companies will be linked below. We used the most recent quarterly data where we could, except Texas Instruments, which is full year 2023. For Micron Technology, we used the last two quarters averaging data as the previous quarter losses would have skewed the comparables too much. We added in the 10-for-1 split for Broadcom, expected July the 13th. So the average share price is $154, with Intel being the cheapest. Nvidia has the greatest market cap at over $3.2 trillion. Broadcom is valued at $831 billion. The medium market cap is $213 billion. Nvidia earned $80 billion in the last four quarters as the leader, with Intel second at $55 billion and Broadcom third with nearly $43 billion. If we take ARM Holdings revenue out, we get an industry average of a little over $39 billion. Gross margins are averaging 58%, with ARM Holdings at 95% and Micron 22.7%. ARM is a fabless semiconductor provider, earning royalties and licensing fees. Intel and Broadcom have the highest assets. Cash and marketable securities have NVIDIA and Intel in the lead, with over $52 billion between them. Average cash is almost $13 billion. Broadcom and Qualcomm have the highest free cash flow, with ARM and Texas Instruments the least, but all positive. Broadcom and Intel carry the largest debt burden at over $124 billion, where the average is just $22 billion. ARM Holdings have no debt. Intel is spending over $800 billion on PPE and research and development. If we remove Intel, average CapEx is $7.5 billion. The average earnings per share is $2.78, with ARM, AMD, and Intel in the low end. Qualcomm and Texas Instruments earned an impressive $7.42 and $7.07, respectively. PE ratios average 52.6 without Advanced Micro Devices and ARM Holdings, whose PEs are 260 and 630, respectively. Qualcomm and Texas Instruments have a PE of just 28 and Intel 36. Enterprise value to free cash flow tell us how much investors are willing to pay for each dollar of free cash flow. NVIDIA is the highest at 390. If we remove that data point, the average is 56.6, putting Micron, Intel, and Qualcomm on the lower end. Enterprise value to sales has ARM trading at 59 times and NVIDIA at 37 times, suggesting both the companies are overvalued. Without these two data points, the average would be 10.3, putting Intel, Qualcomm, and Micron on the undervalued side. Enterprise value to EBITDA has ARM at a whopping 700 times. Taking out that value, the industry average is 34.7, putting both Micron and Intel on the cheaper end. Return on assets as a whole for the industry aren't great, with NVIDIA at 55% and Qualcomm at 20% as the exception. An honorable mention to Qualcomm as well. Removing NVIDIA, average ROA is just 7.5%. CapEx to sales tells us how much revenue is being invested into future revenue. No surprise that Intel is investing more than its revenue into the firm at 1.46 times. ARM Holdings at 0.64 is spending on research and development rather than property, plant, and equipment. Broadcom and NVIDIA are just 0.19 and 0.12 times, respectively, but remember, they both have high revenues. CapEx to sales average 0.33 times when Intel is not included in the average. Debt to EBITDA shows that Broadcom and Intel have the highest debt load and ARM Holdings have none. NVIDIA has just 0.2 and AMD only 0.45. Taking Broadcom's data point out, the average is 1.05. Conclusions: the semiconductor industry as a whole is overpriced. AMD and ARM prices are not justified. Intel is underpriced with respect to the industry, making huge investments in CapEx. Lots of debt, but one to watch. Micron Technology should see earnings improve and PE come down. Texas Instruments and Qualcomm have the greatest potential upside. NVIDIA is overpriced, though is the leader in the semiconductor industry. Broadcom has a lot of debt and return on assets is just 5%. We have no exposure to these companies. Like and subscribe.